This is really exciting. There was a really cool paper the other day that, maybe it was a few weeks ago, that came out in Cell Metabolism. And the thing that I really like about Cell Metabolism is that they try to do the translational research between looking at mechanisms and also doing something very practical in humans. So they took a group of people with fatty liver and they put them on a ketogenic diet. And they found some really interesting things over time. So they only did this for 2 weeks, so very different in scale in terms of what we're doing with our trial. But they brought the people in, they did all of their baseline measurements on them, and in just one day, they saw a significant reduction in fat content in the liver. And I think it was reduced by almost half after 14 days at the end. And then just to make sure that the ketogenic diet was the driver behind that change in their liver fat content, after the people ended the study and they went back to consuming their typical diet, they brought 10 of their subjects back in 1 to 3 months later and measured their liver fat content again and saw it return almost back up to baseline in just that 1 to 3 months after they had completed the intervention. So I think this is really interesting, and it's showing a lot of promise in terms of different ways that we can use nutrition to treat fatty liver. And, you know, if we're not, if we can cut down some of the fat content and explore some of these mechanisms, I think it's going to be a really interesting research area.
Yeah. This is a real paradox because, again, I said before, there is this common myth that you are what you eat. And people assume, well, if you eat a high-fat diet, then all that fat's going to go through your digestive system and end up in your liver. But that's not what happens. The liver becomes very efficient at clearing the fat. Some of it is made into ketones. Maybe as much as 100 grams of fat is made into ketones by the liver each day when somebody's on a well-formulated ketogenic diet. So the liver is not a place where the fat goes to hide or reside when you're keto-adapted. And there's more research being done on that. My co-author and scientific collaborator and very good friend, Dr. Jeff Volek at Ohio State University, is doing some very precise imaging studies on people on a ketogenic diet over a 3-month period of time. And that research should hopefully be published later this year. We're looking at more sophisticated biomarkers in our Lafayette research study, and hopefully we'll be publishing that data shortly as well.
Yeah, this study did a really nice look at some of the underlying mechanisms to show that de novo lipogenesis was actually slowed. They showed the increased rate of ketone production, so they were showing that beta oxidation rates were going up. So they did a really nice, I think, elegant job of showing some of those very early changes even before adaptation occurred, potentially, because they were seeing those changes in 3, 5, 7 days.
Mm. And stepping back a bit, just up until 4 or 5 years ago, there were very few people doing research.
Well-done
research on ketogenic diets. You know, in fact, life was kind of lonely back then.
Yeah.
And we're seeing more and more really top-notch research groups getting engaged in this area. And I think we'll, you know, it's good to have more good minds looking at this. Mm-hmm. And, again, our job is not to prove we're right, but to, you know, find out where we're wrong and correct those things. And it's really great to see other people coming in who, you know, aren't considered advocates in this area, doing high-quality research, such as this recent paper in Cell Metabolism.